What's funny, I remember on our the afternoon of when that night was going to be our 35th high school reunion, a man that I went to school with put up on Facebook, "I hope Frank doesn't bring up all the mean, nasty, and stupid things that I did in high school." And
yeah,
I reassured him on Facebook that wasn't going
to
happen.
You don't have to bring it up. But this is curious to me because I was, I don't know, I was both bullied and a little bit of a bully in high school. And I remember every bad thing I've ever done and hold it against myself in a very, very negative way. And it's hard for me to let go and forgive myself for things that I know. And I know people who I've been through life with and then see them years later and they'd forget how I was a dick to them. But I remember. And I sometimes I will bring it up and sometimes I won't, depending on if I can trust that they are not going to like get all crazy about it. But it's interesting that I hold on to those memories in a strong way. So do you study, I know you studied psychology, but do you study the function of memory and how it progresses and how it works?
Well, I think there's, in a way, memory can be, like you might be holding on to those bullying memories to make sure that you never do anything like that again. You have to hold on to it. And I think a lot of our brains are kind of naturally geared towards remembering bad things and thinking about unsolved problems because the original function of thinking was survival back in caveman times. So we need to remember the bad more than good to survive.
Good point. And that's a very comfortable thing that you've offered me that I can latch onto and thinking that there's a noble reason that I remember these things and hopefully that I won't do them again.